Come on, give God some praise. Come on, give God some praise. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. You can do a little better than that. I'm quite, some of you were more excited last night watching the fight. But how many know that God woke us up this morning and He started us on our way? He gave us the activity of our limbs. So all over the room, let's just put our hands together and give God a great praise. How many know that we serve a mighty God? We serve a great God. We serve a powerful God. Somebody said, I know Him to be a healer. Somebody said, I know Him to be a way maker. So if you know that He has those things to you, I dare you to open up your mouth and just give God some glory. Oh.
able today? Anybody know he's able today? Anybody know he's able today? Don't give up on God because he's able. Don't give up on him. I know that he's able. He's able to do what he said he'll do. Oh, he's able. Anybody know he's able? You just can't give up on him. I say, oh, no, don't give up.
My God. We thank God for the shepherd of this house. The Pastor Eric, Vincent Thomas. Let's give our leader a thunderous applause today. Well, you can do better than that. I'm quite sure you had the football game. You clapped real good. I'm quite sure when you saw the fight, you was whooping. But we thank God for the leader, the teacher, and the singer shepherd of this house. God bless you, Pastor Thomas. We thank God for all of the ministers and sheriff here today. It's good to be home. Praise the Lord. I say it's good to be home. We thank God for those who travel today. The exciting thing when I saw my little kindergarten student here today, Darren is sitting. Darren, just wave your hand for me, son. That's my little kindergarten student. Amen. We're so happy. We thank God for Dr. Margaret and Moore, Sister April, and from the Church of God in Christ. And we thank God for you, Sister Wise. We thank God for you, Ms. Mitchell. We thank God for all of those who have traveled and come today to hear a word from the Lord. I was so good when I come this way. It's good to see those that knew me when. But look at me now. I don't think you caught that. I said knew me when. But look at me now. I thank God. I said I thank God. He didn't count me out. Oh, come on somebody. And we thank God for Felicia Moore, the city council of the 9th district, who's running for president of the board of councilors for city of Atlanta. Please stand, Councilman Moore. She is the district 9 is where Atlanta is. We thank God for Councilman Moore being here today. Amen. Amen. It's just good to be in God's presence because God is just good. With everything that's going on in the world, God is just good. I don't have a long word, but I got a strong word. And you know what we have to understand in life is that God is so supernatural, unbelievable, unbelievable, with all things that he does for us. That's the reason why everything that's going on around us, if you're a child of the King, you shouldn't have no worry. Amen. Thank you, Elder Mary, for that. If you turn over to the book of Genesis, the 19th chapter and the 26th verse, there are various other scriptures in this particular text. But I'm just going to key on the verse that our subject topic comes from this morning. If those of you can stand to reference the word of God, I am one of the elders at the House of God, Church of God in Christ. Bishop Mark Walden is our very fine leader and pastor of the Second Ecclesiastical Jury District of the Church of God in Christ. Amen? Amen. I read in your hearing, God, we thank you for your word today. God, we thank you for the man of God. Take Terrance out the way and put you in the way that somebody will hear a supernatural word that will supernatural change their lives, God, that would enhance their life and make them greater today, God. And we thank you. God, we bind every sickness in the name of Jesus. We loose every root of cancer. We say regulate high blood pressure and diabetes, God. God, we thank you for being the miracle, God, the miracle worker. God, we speak now, Holy Spirit, God, come down like a great mighty fire. Storm wind, come in, God. Touch the corners of these walls, God. Touch our minds, God, that when we leave here, we'll be renewed and we'll have a new word for a new day in the name of Jesus. And so it is, we say amen.
Amen.
In this book of Genesis, the 19th chapter and the 26th verse, but his wife looked back from behind him, and she became a pillar of salt. I come to you talking of the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. Abraham was declared unto them to take them eastward to the mountains. But his wife looked behind him and became a pillar of salt. You may be seated. I will flip over to Philippians, the sub scripture.
for our subject matter this morning in Philippians 3, 13 and 14. Brethren, count not yourself to be apprehended, but this one thing. I forget those things which are behind and reach forward unto those things which are before. I press towards the prize of the higher calling of God in Christ Jesus. I stop by to tell you, don't look behind. Look forward and reach to your destiny. We find ourselves sometimes in a look behind mode. In this particular text in Genesis, it talked about this very sinful place. A place where God just said, we can't do nothing with this. He said, Abraham, I need you to go into this city and tell Lot to gather his family up and come out of the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. See, sometime in our life, we assume and we're caught up in the fire. But what we do, we carry ourselves and we continue to look behind, and that's the reason we can't look, get anything forward. Because we hold on to what happened then, that's the reason we can't get what's ahead of us. Well, Lot's wife, when I understood and came to the realization, Lot's wife, she loved the fanfare of living in the city. That sometimes you just can't let some things go. Oh, somebody talk back to me. Have you ever been there in a place that you may have a pair of shoes, have a certain piece of clothing that you've had so long, but you know it's no more good, but you just don't want to let it go? Are you cooking a certain pot that the pot just came to be black as tar? You done did everything you can do to get the pot back right, but you got to let it go. Oh, somebody, I know it's all somebody in here that don't want to let some things go. Come on, talk back to me. Been in relationships, and you know it's a bad thing, and I just don't want to let it go. All right, you go and say amen. I must be the only one in here. But we have to learn how to let it go. See, the reason I just come to set the house in order. And see, some of you need to listen to the old, because the old can tell you something. All this new school stuff. I said, all this new school stuff, this new church stuff, but you better get back to the fundamentals, because see, everything goes in a cycle. I said, everything goes in a cycle. You know, Afro were back in the day before wearing Afros now. I'm trying to go somewhere. And see, you wondering and pondering where the church is going. Where are we going from here? What's going to happen now? Well, if you keep praying and asking God to do it, you'll see what's going to happen. If you stay off the telephone and stop talking and start praying and read your Bible and say, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He's making me to lie down and green pastures. He's leading me beside the still waters. You ain't go out walking the shepherd. Well, you say, in the book It says, touch not my prophet. Anointed and do him no harm. For he is called by me. See, you can't touch the prophet. Because see, if I get a prophet of war, I'm going to get a prophet of war. But there is a but. There is a but. If you really want God to do it, if you really want to get to the next level, you have to come out the sheep clothing that you eat. The Bible says anything with two hands shall die. They ain't worth having. God is not a God of discord. And you can't run God's house like you run your house. St. Peter, we're living in a time that if we ever want the Lord, we sure need him now. And because he's an omnipotent God, he got the power. Isn't anybody who wants something from the Lord? Why don't you just stand and just clap your hand? You got to put a praise on it. You got to put a praise on it. Well, I gotta go. But as I go down, when I think about it, I look up here and see these items. You can sit down because I'm getting ready to go. And you say to me, young man, I need a little something. I gotta get out of here. And you say, what are these things up here? Why do this man got these items up here? Well, since you've been trying to look back and you can't move forward, I got to pick up my tide. Because tide, I'm tired in the Lord. When you're tied up and you're chained up, you got to know tide can do the trick. Can somebody say, you've come for. I don't know what you need him for. But can I give you a word beyond a word today? Can I tell you when you leave here, your life will never be the same? Your situation will never be the same. You know why? Because great is he that is in you. You ought to clap your hand right there. See, can I tell you something? I played with him a long time. But one day something happened to me. And I got a hold of the real thing. And when I got a hold to the real thing, it changed my life beyond greatness. And nobody can do you like Jesus, people.
Thank you. I see you doing it for God.